In the metals quadrant today, let's take a look at gold, which had a negative day, but really overall in price action analysis, you would call this stable looking at the way that it traded and the way that it finished in the context of the prior four sessions. You had a low of about 1637.70, and that actually happened after gapping open and then running to a high in the June contract of 1661. We then fell down to the lows in gold and then slowly rallied back to leave sort of a long tail if you're looking at a candlestick chart. When you look at the past four bars, essentially the bullish pattern is still intact for gold. So you're looking at a stable but lower gold price today in terms of the overall outlook for the precious metal. Now, the gold-silver ratio fell again today, so that's two of the last 3 days that we've seen lower on the gold-silver ratio. For those of you that don't know, again, gold-silver ratio is the amount of ounces of silver it would take to buy 1 ounce of gold, and today that was right around 111.5, 112. We saw what some people were calling a 5,000-year high at 127 intraday a little while ago. Now, that didn't really hold. Plus, I don't know if it's a 5,000-year high. I went back to 1915 and saw that it's the high for that period from now to 1915. And then pulling back from there is a pretty healthy thing, basically showing you that silver's outperforming just a touch. And then lastly, looking at the dollar index was lower today. It's the fourth consecutive day lower. We fell below 99 on the dollar index. So it's been a bit of a dramatic move considering how quickly we ramped up through those 100 handles that we got through, peaking out at slightly above 104. So there's a little bit of weakness there. So that's always going to be a little bit of a tailwind to gold when you see that inverse relationship kind of taking hold. So gold negative today, about $7.80 or so, but really still within that bullish pattern.